You can get comfy in your easy seat, free seat, or half lotus, whatever makes you comfy. You can pop your cushion under your bum if that also aids you, or a pillow from your bed, whatever works. And we're just gonna do normal in and out breathing, but we're gonna work with our count of nine. So I'm wanting you to try and expand your lungs and your belly as you breathe in for a count of nine, and then you try and deflate as much, like every little piece of air that you can get out for your count of nine. But we're gonna go slow and progressively. So I'm gonna take you through the first two counts, and obviously if my count's too slow for you, you just carry on with your own count after those two rounds. Okay. So, hands can be on your knees or in your lap. And let's begin. Inhale. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Exhale. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Inhale. Two. Three. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Exhale, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Keep going at your own pace. Slow and steady inhales. Slow and steady exhales. finish up your last round and allow your breathing to return to its natural rhythm. Your right hand and grab the top of the left side of your head, lifting it up and over that tennis ball on your right shoulder. To the other side. Take your chin to your right armpit, pulling the head towards your armpit. Extend your left arm up towards the ceiling and bend it back, touching your hand between your scapula. And go to the other side. Extend your right arm up, bending the elbow, placing your hand between your two scapula. And release. We're gonna feel our chin pulling backwards, so it stretches into the occipitals just at the base of our skull. So you're just having your normal head and you pull the chin backwards just for a few seconds and release, and then pull your chin back, release, pull your chin back and release. Now we're going to feel that pulled chin backwards turning to the right shoulder, and then we're going to take our pointy finger and middle finger and push it against our skull, and the skull pushes back, so we're creating a little bit of tension or resistance. Release and resist. Release and resist. And go over to the other side. Remember, our chin's pulling back. We turn to our left shoulder and then we push against our fingers. Release and resist. Release and resist. And relax. We're going to interlace our fingers behind our head, and we're going to push our head against our hands and our hands against our head, but we're not bringing our chin towards our chest. We're keeping our head in position or looking forward. Roll your shoulders backwards and forwards. Twist towards the left and the right and the left and the right and the left and the right. And you can move your cushions or anything else you had in your way out the way. And if you've got your socks on, you might want to snatch those off as well. Okay, so we're going to start off lying on our backs. Feet can come up close to your bum, or as close to your bum as you can get them. And we're going to feel this arch that's happening in the back here. And we want to go from the arch to pulling the spine down towards the floor. So we're getting into these lower ab muscles. So you allow the arch. And then you can even place your hands on your hip bones and feel as the hip bones pull up, then your spine's on the floor and it's getting into these lower tummy muscles. Release into the arch and then lift. Release into the arch and then lift. Release. Release, lift, release, lift. Now we're going to hold it for a bit. You might want to take your fingers and just feel, are you activating nicely in the lower abs? Can you feel these muscles working? Relax. We're going to move into traverse muscle activation. So we're going to lift our head and our shoulders off the floor, lift the left knee up at about a 90 degree, place your right hand against that knee and push against the knee, and the knee pushes against the hand. You should again be feeling tummy muscles. Place that leg down and go over to the right leg, left knee. Right leg, left hand, and swap over. If you find it a bit uncomfortable in the neck, you can keep the neck or the head down on the floor and still activate, pushing the hand into the knee, knee into the hand. These guys still work. Swap. 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 Pull your knees into your chest. Take a moment. We're going to go into our spinal rolls. So you can place your hands onto the tops of your shins. You're going to be pushing the legs into the hands to help you roll up. but you might want to bring your legs slightly over to help you get momentum to start rolling up. Just like so. Keep going, rolling the spine. You want to really round. And that rounding, it's again, your tummy muscles are activating, pulling backwards to create that rounding in the spine to help you roll just like a ball up and down. Now try going a little bit slower with your rolls. So we're going to use our legs to help us slow down. So we're going to start rolling down, and as we roll, the legs start straightening and then slowly come up. Legs are straighter and then we come to a bend. So just play with that. You've got to find your own sort of momentum when you're straightening out the legs. Roll up and you keep yourself in this upright position, trying to balance on the coccyx. If you find it a little bit challenging playing with these coccyx, remember cushions sit behind your bum to help prop you up, or you can pop it under your bum to help you feel more comfortable. Just find that spot that helps you keep that balance point, if that makes sense. Again, the tummy is active the whole time, so we're sucking belly back to lift through the spine. So these guys up the sides of your body, your obliques are working to help lift through the body. We're going to grab our knees, under our knees, and we're going to work on stretching one leg straight, or as straight as you can get it, and back. And then the other, and back. Keep swapping. Keep going. Last round. And come back, releasing your knees and extend your arms out to the sides. Just trying to hold this position. Slowly start moving towards the floor, straightening the legs. Try and keep your body off the floor until the very last second, and you release down, lying flat on your mat. We're going to place our hands under our bum cheeks. Find that more comfy spot. Sometimes I get to a place where I actually feel like I'm clicking my wrists. So you might actually want to bend your elbow slightly to get a nice comfortable spot on the wrist so you don't get sore or uncomfortable. Okay, so from here, we're going to bring our legs up towards the ceiling. We're going to flex our feet, and our knees are slightly bent. And if you find that you go into your lower back, don't be afraid to bend your knees even more. Our focus is on our tummy muscles, not so much where the legs are perfectly straight. Okay, so from here, we're going to just feel those tummy muscles pulling down towards the floor so that it lifts the coccyx slightly off the hands. Just get into the tummy and lift the coccyx off the floor. Feel like we're pushing one leg straight, sucking the belly down, and then push the other leg straight, sucking the belly down. Keep alternating. You want to really feel like you're pushing through the one leg as it's straightened. The leg activates. You should feel your quads working. The calf should be working because your feet are nice and flexed. Swap. Push through the straightening leg. Remember, your tummy should still be active. And swap. And swap. And swap. Swap. And let both knees bend a little bit more. Maybe, 65 degree angle. They're not like bent, but you've got a bigger bend than you had when we first did the first round. And you're trying to lift your coccyx off a little bit more. So you're creating a little bit of momentum. And in that momentum, so it's momentum and then push. And momentum and push. Momentum and push. Try not to go into the shoulder muscles as you're pushing. You want to feel the tummy muscles sort of propelling you up and your bum muscles squeezing up. The neck and the shoulders should just be chilling. Take a break, pulling your knees into your armpits, grabbing your feet, and up into happy baby. Start imagining that you're driving a truck with your feet, and you're just twist from side to side in your happy baby. And release the feet down into a Supta Arkonasana, interlacing your fingers around your toes and allowing your head to come up, and you're leaning back so you can feel the stretch going through the trapezius muscles. Push your feet into your hands and release. Push. Release. And push.
feet come forward towards our face and give ourselves a propulsion up until we can roll into our Baddha Konasana. Oh, my mind this morning. Pull the sternum down towards your toes. Coming onto our hands and feet. So you've got your toes tucked under behind you, not flat on the floor. And you're going to push through the arms, lifting through the armpits. Feel the tummy lifting, hips are tucking under. We're going to lean backwards, getting into the toes, and then lift the knees up off the floor. Lift the bum up as if you were going to go to your downward facing dog, but the knees stay bent. Lean forward over that 90 degree wrist spot and take the knees back towards the floor, but don't put them on the floor. And go again. It's like we're creating a little churning motion. Feel the tummy is working. Feel the legs working. Feel the arms pushing into the ground. And take a break, coming into child's pose. Instead of extending our arms ahead or behind us, we're just going to knot our hands into fists and place our head on our fists. Lean forward and walk your arms forward, because we're going to be in a plank position. So find the spot on your mat that gets you to the front comfortably. And we're taking our arms into a forearm leaning position, but the hands turning in. And then we're stacking the hands on top of each other. Then lean to get the shoulders stacking on top of the elbows and straighten your legs out behind you. We're going to lean into our right arm, twisting our feet to the right and lifting the right arm up towards the ceiling. Left arm towards the ceiling. Make sure you're lifting through the armpit and you're not collapsing in your shoulder. And swap to the other side. Remember, there's a hot lava pot underneath you, so you're lifting up in your side muscles. Twist over. Twist over. Twist over. Twist over. Come back to your plank and lean forward. Placing your hands in front of you, going into your Sphinx pose. Remember, we squeeze our bum, pushing the forksy bonnet forward, and feel like you're pulling your sternum forward. placing your hands under your shoulders. And we're going to push up into our upward facing dog. So first, let's go through cobra, keeping the chin tucked. As you come up, lift through the feet. Lift into plank. And push up into your downward facing dog. Lean forward into your plank position again. Press through those legs. And push up into downward facing dog. And into plank. And downward facing dog. Bend the knees. And we're going to bounce our left leg forward into our high lunge position. Find that right positioning. Find my legs are so long. I think I've got the right positioning as I kick forward, then I feel like that back leg plays games with me. So you find it, if you need to hop forward, you need to hop back, find your spot. Push through this front leg, you lift. Once you feel like you've got your balance and you're activating your back bum nicely, we're going to take our arms up towards the ceiling. Then we're going to smack our hands together and come into our cactus position. So we're opening the chest up, we're going into a little bit of an arch. Then we're going to interlace our fingers behind our back, straighten the front leg, and we're going to start leaning forward, trying to drop our sternum to our thigh, but you just go as far as is comfortable. And slowly lift. And bend the front knee again. Release the hands. Come up into your cactus. And reach the arms up. And go into a slight back bend. And then we're going to feel a bit of momentum as we push through the front leg and we come forward with our right foot. Coming into our Utkatasana. Hands are at the side, so it's not quite airplane arms, but they're almost in line with your hips. Just so that we can now lean on the right leg and sweep back into our high lunge with the left. Reach up high. Clap your hands together and bring into your cactus position. Slight arch happening. Then interlace your hands behind your back. Straighten your front leg. And you start leaning forward. Go as far down as you're comfortable. And slowly come up. Bending that front leg. Bring your hands up into your cactus position, going into your arch. Straighten your arms up towards the ceiling, creating more of an arch if you're able. And we're going to bring our hands towards the floor. Staying in your high lunge. push through the arms, sending your right leg back. So you go into your downward facing dog. Lean forward into your plank. Back up. Plank. Back up. Plank. Back up. Bending knees. And we bounce forward with the right leg coming into our high lunge position. Again, if you need to play with that back foot, forward, backwards, up and down, whatever you need to do. Then feel stabilization going through your front leg as you lift into your high lunge. Feel this back bar muscle working to help stabilize you. And we lift our hands up towards the ceiling. Clap. Cactus arms. Interlace your hands behind your back. Straighten your front leg. And slowly come forward. And up. Bending that front leg. Pull those arms back a little bit more. Go into your arch already. Release. Cactus arms. Then straighten into your crescent lunge. And then we're going to feel a bit of momentum as we come forward. Oh, I didn't pull that one off very well. Into our Utkatasana. Hands in line with our bum. We lean into our left leg. And we send our right leg back. Oh, sorry guys, I'm destabilizing. Into our high lunge. Arms sweep up. Clap. Cactus arms, interlace behind your back, straighten your front leg, and lean forward. Slowly come up, bending the front leg. And lift your arms high up behind you, going into that lunge, going into that arch. Release the hands, come up to cactus arms, and straighten your arms into your crescent lunge. Sweep your arms forward, placing them on the floor. Push through the hands. Into your plank position, lift into your downward facing dog, bend the knees, sucking your belly up, and hold. Take a step forward with your feet and push through the arms. Step with your feet and push through the arms. Step with your feet and push through the arms and come all the way down onto your hands and knees. Oh, sitting on your feet, we're going to do a few gentle twists. So you're lifting in the tummy, tucking your coccyx gently under. We're taking our right hand across to our left knee and our left arm is wrapping around our torso. And twist open to the left. And over to the other side. Your fingers behind your back. You can have your palms open or close together. Close together just gives you a deeper stretch. Extend the arms back behind you as far as you can go and lean forward. Head on the floor, lift the arms and feel like they're being pulled up towards the ceiling. Come up. Open your knees and open your feet up so that you can sit your bum on the floor. If this is quite challenging, take one leg straight in front of you. We're just going into a quad stretch, so if you're not able to do both legs at the same time, one at a time is perfect. If you do your one at a time, try and bring the knee closer or the knees closer together as you lean back. If you're playing with me in our double-legged one, you can have them close or wider. It actually just gets into different areas of your quads, so maybe do both. Experiment, play with your body here. So again, we want to feel that tucking the coccyx under, lifting in the belly, and leaning backwards. You can see I'm not placing my hands on the floor yet, so this is a bit of an active work. So you find that point where, you know, if you lean any further back, you're just going to, the knees are going to flop up and you're going to hold it there. So again, you're feeling your tummy muscles working. Then place your hands on the floor. Find your comfortable spot. If you need to place your hands or your arms straight behind you and that gets you into your quad stretch, that's cool. If you're good on your elbows, that's where you go to. And if you can lie down, that's where you go to. Just make sure the knees aren't lifting up off the floor. If you're doing one leg, you need to swap so that you get your other leg in. And slowly release your legs. Pulling your knees into your chest. What we're going to play with is, and it's up to you how comfortable you feel in your legs. Ooh, I'm about to choke. Breathing in your own saliva. Sorry, guys. Okay, so you can bring your feet together and go into a Supta Barakonasana, or if it's a little bit more comfortable, you go into your Sukhasana, so your ankles cross over each other. And also play with the swapping of the legs, which one's more comfortable. And then you can get ready for relaxation. So we're going to place our one hand on our heart, the other one sort of in your, maybe across your belly button. So it's sort of in between your solar plexus and your sacrum. And we're going to start breathing in our green, yellow, orange energies. So as you breathe in, imagine these sort of swirls of colorful smoke coming in through the crown and being pulled through your body. So it's not that we're aiming to pull them into the heart and the solar plexus and the sacrum explicitly, but rather just those energies being pulled through the whole body. So it's love energy, it's creative energy, it's stable, safe, and secure energy that's just emanating through the entire body. And each breath, we're just bringing more and more of these colorful smokes into the body, feeling them just dispersing everywhere. Slow inhales, and the green smoke starts to pull. Then the orange adds to it. Then the yellow. And these three tendrils of smoke pull in through the crown. Down through the body, and just feel like it disperses into each and every little molecule of your being. Imagine the colors of the smoke getting stronger and more vibrant. The vibrancy moves through your body. Body getting full up that love frequency. Full up with that creativity. Full up security and stability. Thank you. breath in through the nose, out through the mouth. Deep breath in as you pull your knees to your chest. And exhale. Deep breath in. And we're going to get our knees to help us up to our seated position. We're just going to finish off with one closing om. Hands can be on your knees or into your heart center. Deep breath in. Om. Thank you, everybody.